Hi. So you're asking yourself, should I go, should I not go? Should I try and do it? What if I try and do it, it works, and then what if it doesn't work? You have this opportunity ahead of you, and you're feeling like, well, I don't know if it's going to work. Or you're working on a project, and you're asking yourself questions like, what if nothing good comes of it? There might just be that ray of hope, and you're afraid to take the leap. Now, so I'm going to tell you a story of how I followed my heart and took the leap, and it paid off in the end. It's a Sunday morning, 9 a.m. to be precise. I'm walking back and forth my room. Questions like, what if I go and he slaps me? What if he sends me out of the room? Should I go? Should I not go? The battle in my mind. My mind becomes like a battleground. Now, as you ask the questions, I'm referring to my father. Whether I should go and meet him or not to go and meet him. 2 weeks before that Sunday, I failed the national exams needed for me to get into the university. My father is disappointed because he has spent so much money, paid a whole lot, for me to take lessons as to pass this exam, but I failed. Now, the only alternative is for me to take the diploma exams. These diploma exams cost a fortune. Well, from an average family, son, we can't afford that. You have to go to a polytechnic. My father says to me just 2 days ago, I don't know what to do. That's why these questions come to my mind. Should I go? Should I not go? Should I go and meet him? Should I go and talk to him or not? But that morning, I summoned courage, opened the door to my room, and walked straight down to my father's room. I knock. Come in, says. Good morning, Daddy, I greet. I'm still afraid in my mind. I don't know what to do. But I just go and go ahead. Good morning, he says. How was your night? Thank you, sir. Daddy, I can do this through my exams and excel at it. I know it's a whole lot of money, but please, can we just find a way to waste the money so I can go to university? I don't want to go to a polytechnic. I pitched to him. He's putting on his agbada clothes, preparing for church too. And just as he tries to button the lash button at the top there, he says, looking straight into my eyes, okay, son, we'll give it a try. We'll find a way to raise the money. And yes, that was it. I took that step of faith, not listening to those thoughts that said it would not agree for me to take those exams. I didn't listen to them. I took that step of faith and he agreed. He allowed me to take the exams. And he paid. And today, yes, I'm a graduate of the university. So what am I saying to you? You're probably working on your project and you're asking yourself questions. Is there going to be anything good that will come of this project? And there might just be that way of hope that something will come up. Don't give up on the project. Keep at it. Or maybe you have a job. And then maybe you feel like quitting the job will be the solution to all your problems. You don't know how it's going to be. You don't know your next line of action. But you just feel like quitting the job will be the solution. Take that step. Don't be afraid. Take that leap. In my own case, if I did not take the leap, maybe I would have gone to the polytechnic today. But I took that leap. The worst that could have happened would have been you have said no. But indeed he said yes, and I took the leap. So once again, my message to you is, don't be afraid. Take that leap. If there's that rule, follow it. Thank you so much.